is money. And one of the things we are talking about is that they has also to finance this commitment. You see, the problem of energy in Nigeria is not something you begin to look at. You must look at short-term measures. And one of the critical short-term measures is the cutting-edge technology of small reactor, nuclear reactor technology, which is properly secured and then used for electricity. And the good thing about it is that you don't require fuel for this technology until after 7 years of its use. And then it can be deployed primarily to what we call the energy spots, for example, at industrial centers, at city centers, where you require 5 megawatts, 10 megawatts, 15 megawatts, and all that. And you don't even require to use the transmission lines. That is the good thing about this. It's on the spot technology. And then you bring it, you install it, and then it begins to work. What we require is a license, and then it will be gone through the technology providers. And this is where America has done wonderfully well in the area of technology. Then, looking at the other issue of housing, by the time you begin to provide electricity, you must also look at people living well. You must provide housing for the people. And in order to provide housing for the people, we have to talk about discarding the anticipated technology of building blocks that will take several years to complete. We are talking about cutting-edge technology, prefabricated housing schemes that will have better properties than we are doing today, and then structuring payment and buying proposals for the civil servants, for the poor people, for the technicians, and artisans to live well. Now, if that is done, then we are looking at the issue of deployment of our PAM. You know, we are trying to convert our wide PAMs into plywood and building materials, which is going to offer employment to not less than 50,000 youths. So these are issues we have been able to enter into. And it requires little or no funding from us, because we've got what it takes. Everything we have today becomes our own equity to the entire venture.
Geographically, how does it cover today?
I don't know what you mean by geographically. The nuclear reactor electricity does not cover the entire state. We are looking at energy spots. The energy spots include our city, which is the Owerri capital city. We are looking at our industrial park in Owerri, and we are looking at our new city development in Ugbuta, where we are siting most of our industrial ventures. I want to tell you that the best thing that has happened to Nigeria in recent time is the visit of the acting president to the United States. One thing people must note is that the acting president came for a seminar on nuclear security. But with the way America accepted him, the way America received him, it looks like a well-planned state visit, even better than a state visit. And the perception of Nigeria has dramatically shot up, the way stock shot up in the stock market. And the way the people who hold the levers of power have expressed their wish to now deploy Nigeria as the anchor for their newfound hope on development and economic development of America also, using Nigeria, is worthy of mention. And our acting president took the bull by the horn, a man who never misses every opportunity offered him. He said it the way it is. He elaborated on the issue of election and reform. He talked about technological issues. He looked at issues of relationship. He looked at issue of security, kidnapping, issue of small armed proliferation in the whole of African, more especially the sub-Saharan African countries. And then America has they rolled out their red carpet, and then have now understood Nigeria, listing Nigeria from the Nigerian own point of view, not what other people talk about, but what to talk about ourselves and talk about other people.